brothers and sisters, what a joy it is to be in the presence of the Lord and to be able to worship the Lord again in spirit and in truth. And so we're grateful this morning that you have tuned in one more time, amen, to worship the Lord. And we're grateful for all of you today for tuning in. We're having a few issues with Facebook. So for those who are on Facebook, we're going to still keep working and try to get connected. But we're going to move on in the name of the Lord with this word that the Lord has given us. We have a little winter mix going on this morning, a little snow falling, but it's all right in Jesus' name, because we're comfortable and we're home and we're able to still enjoy the presence of the Lord. So real quick, why don't you turn with me to 1 Corinthians chapter 10 and verse 13. While you're turning to that, please hit the share button. We want to make sure everybody is blessed with the word of the Lord. By you hitting the share button, it could very well cause some new people to come on and to be able to catch us and hear a word from the Lord. 1 Corinthians chapter 10 and verse 13, I'm reading from the Message version. And this is what it says. No test or temptation that comes your way is beyond the course of what others have had to face. All you need to remember is that God will never let you down. He'll always be there to help you come through it. With that verse of scripture in mind this morning, my brothers and sisters, we want to preach from the subject, built for the moment. Built for the moment. If we're honest, we all face pressures and temptations in life where we feel overwhelmed, and these pressures and temptations that we face from time to time can come in many different shapes and sizes, such as obstacles that looks too big and overwhelming at times, obstacles and situations where we never dreamed we would be dealing with. We thought that the trouble, amen, and disunity in the family would be over by now, or we would be out of debt, where we will no longer have to rob Peter to pay Paul. It's easy to feel like it's too much and we can't take it anymore. But 1 Corinthians chapter 10 and verse 13 helps us and encourages us in the time of our temptations. God will never let you face anything that you can't handle, but he will make a way of escape so you will be able to bear it. Here in 1 Corinthians chapter 10 and verse 13, we find Paul the apostle trying to convey to us that God does not promise to keep us, or keep our lives from free from difficulties and dangers. He does not pledge to exempt us from fiery trials and troublesome temptations, nor even does he try to prevent persecution. But he does undertake to limit its intensity and provide us a way of escape. So Paul says that we might be able to bear it. Paul the apostle encouraged us as well as warned us to recognize people in situations, amen, that will bring trouble our way. And he encourages us to run from anything you know is wrong and pray for God's help and seek solid biblical friends that will help you when you are tempted. So Paul gives us some encouraging words. He gives us a few nuggets to hold on to help us to know that we're built for this moment. And all of us, even right now this morning, while I'm preaching to you this morning, somebody somewhere that's watching me and listening to me, you are facing some type of situation. You're dealing with some type of temptation. But I'm here to let you know, my brothers and sisters, amen, God will never allow you to enter into any temptations that he can't deliver you out of. So understand, whatever you're dealing with, whatever you're feeling this morning, I want you to lift up your head and I want you to hear this word that God has for you. And so here we are in 1 Corinthians chapter 10 and verse 13. This particular verse here in 1 Corinthians is preceded by a section that uses Israel wilderness wanderings as a witness and warning to the body of Christ. Israel was saved out of Egypt, out of Egypt's oppression by God's grace through faith in God's word. And all who obeyed and applied, amen, the blood of the Passover lamb was passed over by the angel, by the death angel. Like Israel, we too have been saved by grace through faith in God's word and cleansed by the blood of the precious Lamb of God, who the Bible says takes away the sins of the world. By following their miraculous escape from slavery in Egypt and God's covenant to provide for all of their needs, the Bible says some of the children of Israel turned away from God and the God of their salvation and became idol worshipers. Some turned to sexual immorality while others grumbled and complained and spoke evil about the Lord. They did not trust God to provide for their needs, and Paul used Israel's lack of faith in the wilderness as a warning, amen, to the church against unbelief. God promises to Israel and those in the church is to stand fast, amen, forever and ever. And understand, my brothers and sisters, that God has promised that no temptation, hear me when I say this morning, no temptation has overtaken you, but such is common to man. And God is faithful. I need somebody to open up your mouth this morning and speak those words out of your mouth that God is faithful, who will not allow you to be tempted beyond what you are able. But with the temptation, God will provide a way of escape so that you will be able to endure whatever it is that you are facing. Listen, hear me this morning. When God designed you and me, when he dug us up from the clay of the ground, amen, he took into account everything that you and I would ever face in life. Every struggle, every setback, every unfair situation, and he put strength, courage, and determination in us to be able to withstand whatever came our way. And so when you feel overwhelmed, when you feel like the pressure is too much, it's because you are stronger than you think. Yes, yes, I'm here to remind you, it doesn't matter what you're facing right now and how bad the pressure seems against you, you are stronger than what you think. You haven't yet been able to discover all that God has put inside of you. You will never know how strong you really are until you face that pressure that you've never faced before. It may seem unbearable, but the fact of the matter is God allowed it, which means that you can handle it. Anything that God allows to come into your life, amen, whether it takes you by surprise, understand you can handle it. With God, you can handle it. He didn't say he would make a way of escape so you could run from it or so you could avoid it. But 1 Corinthians chapter 10 and verse 13 says, amen, he said he made a way of escape so you could bear it. Somebody said bear it. You can look back at the times when you didn't think you could go on. And all of us got a testimony in our life where at some points in our lives, we were faced with situations and we started complaining and we started to think about giving up and throwing in the towel and saying we can't make it. We can't go through this. The pressure is too much for us. But somehow, saints of God, we're here today as a testimony to say we made it and we were not defeated. You and I, we had the strength to get up, amen, for another day. Amen. You kept going when you didn't feel like you wanted to go. You kept going when you didn't feel like you had anything left. Why didn't it break you? Well, because you are stronger than you thought you was. Amen. You will never know what it is that God has put inside of you until you got your back against the wall, until the pressures of life is coming against you. But hear me this morning. The good news is God designed you to handle that pressure. He wouldn't have allowed that thing to come your direction. Amen. He wouldn't allow that financial pressure, that relationship pressure, that pressure from raising your children, that pressure of dealing with an illness. If that pressure was going to crush you, if it was going to be too unbearable for you, then God would have never allowed it to come your way. But for the mere fact that God allowed it to come your way, it signals to you that he has placed down on the inside of you everything you need to withstand whatever that situation or temptation might be. Amen. God doesn't make any mistakes. He knows exactly what he is doing. Anything you face, amen, you have to remind yourself, amen, that you can handle it. And you have been designed for it. Amen. You were built for the moment. Somebody say built for the moment. Yes, you. Amen. All of those who people talked about and said would never make it, you were built for the moment. Amen. You wouldn't be at the strength, amen, that you would have, amen, if God hadn't given you what you needed to withstand the pressures that was coming against you. Now you have to get in agreement with God, amen, and instead of going around thinking and complaining, saying, this is too much for me. God, what are you thinking about? I can't handle this. Let me tell you, if God said it, if God allowed it, then stand in agreement and say, with God, we can do all things through Christ who strengthened us. I can raise these children. Amen. The pressure at work, amen, will not defeat me. You got to get to that place where you quote the word of God back unto him. And when you quote the word of God back unto him, amen, it holds God accountable to the word that he has spoken over your life. Paul says in Philippians chapter 4 and verse 13, he says, we can do all things through Christ who strengthen us. And let me tell you something, when you're at your weakest moment, when you're faced with temptation, when the pressures of life, amen, is on you and you got your back against the wall, get into the word of God and read the word of God out loud, because, amen, God has to, hear me when I say this, he has to, amen, saints of God, uphold his word. He's a God that cannot lie. And so when we get overwhelmed, we got to get into the word of God, because in God's word, there's always an answer for our situation. We will never face anything or go through anything that the word of God has not already spoken to our situation. So Paul says we can do all things through Christ that strengthen us. Somebody said can do. Yes, that's what you need. You need that can do power. We are well able to overcome, amen, any opposition and outlast any adversity. But I've learned, saints of God, amen, that can do power doesn't do anything for us if we have a can't do mentality. Let me say that again. Amen. Can do power, can't do anything for us if we're walking around and living with a can't do mentality. Quit looking at all the things that you can't do. Amen. Have a new perspective. Start looking out a new set of lens, saying that I can do all things through Christ who strengthened me. I dare somebody watching me this morning, stand up on your feet and quote the word of the living God and say, I can do all things through Christ who strengthened me. And when you say that, when you read the word of God back to him, God is held accountable, amen, to honor his word, amen, over your life. The obstacle may be big, but let me tell you something. You can overcome it through Christ Jesus. This trouble, amen, is, you might be thinking, this trouble is taking too long. It's longer than I thought. But let me tell you something. With that can-do power, you can outlast it. Yes, the situation feels overwhelming. But let me tell you something. Amen. You can handle it. Amen. Because you have been designed. You have been built for the moment. You are strong. You are anointed. And God has equipped you with everything that you need. Amen. When you face something in your life. So don't have a weak mentality. Let me say it again. Do not have a weak mentality. You weren't created to fall apart when the pressures of life come. You are stronger than you think you are. You are more favored than you think you are. You are more anointed than you think you are. Yes, I'm coming to you to feed your spirit, to let you know who you are in Christ Jesus. When you start seeing yourself as strong, as anointed, empowered, and well able, amen, you can outlast that overwhelming spirit. You will discover strength that you have never heard. God's word is just like medicine for our soul, but you got to get in it, you got to read it, and then you got to come in agreement with it. And when you come in agreement with it, that word will come alive in your spirit. And I don't care what you're dealing with, whatever the devil has thrown at you, let me tell you something, when that word pops up inside of you, letting you know who you are, I'm trying to tell somebody this morning, it lets you know you are built for the moment. How do I know this? Because the Bible lets us know. There are many examples in the Word of God to help us to understand, amen, that we are built for the moment. When we feel like we're weak, when we feel like we're not strong enough, when we feel like we're overwhelmed, somehow God got a way of tapping something inside of us to make us wake up and stand up and to know who we are. What are you talking about, Bishop? Well, I'm talking about the story in the Old Testament by a brother by the name of Gideon. The Bible says he was hiding from the Midianites in the wine press. The Bible said he was so afraid. The Midianites were the enemies against God's people. And they had come, amen, to attack God's people. And the Bible says that Gideon, amen, was afraid. And he got into the wine press and he started to hide because he was afraid of the Midianites. And you can imagine the pressure, amen, that was on him and that he was carrying, because inside of him, he thought, amen, that he wasn't strong enough. He thought in his mind that he wasn't able to overcome the enemies that was coming his way. And when you have all of those negative spirits running through your mind and in your spirit, then the devil will have you trembling. But here Gideon was. The Bible says he was hiding in the wine press. But let me tell you something. Just when the enemy thinks that he got you, God loves us so much, he will step in. He will send somebody our way to give us an encouraging word, to light a fire under us, to help us to know who we are. And that's my job this morning, to come this morning and to light a fire under you, to let you know whatever you're facing, you don't have to live in fear. You don't have to walk in fear, but the God that we serve is able to let you know who you are in Christ Jesus. And so the Bible says in Judges chapter 6 and verse 12 that while Gideon was standing there afraid, God sent an angel to tell Gideon, amen, something that he needed to know about himself. Yes, did you hear me this morning? And that's my assignment. God has sent me this morning to tell you something that you need to know about yourself. Maybe you know it, but you need to get it stirred up inside of you. Sometimes, saints of God, if we're going to win this battle, we got to stir up the gift that's inside of us. And so the Bible says that God sent this angel to Gideon and told Gideon, mighty hero, the Lord is with you. One translation says, valiant man of fearless courage. Can't you hear God using that angel to pump encouragement into Gideon to let him know exactly who he was. And the more the angel talked to Gideon and began to say these things about him, something began to happen. Gideon didn't feel like a mighty hero because the Bible says he was hiding in the wine press. He didn't feel like he was courageous, but he felt weak and intimidated. And sometimes, let me help you this morning, the best of us, there are moments we're going to feel like we're intimidated and we're going to feel weak in life. But I want you to know, amen, that when we get to those situations and those temptations that we're facing, God will not leave us there. But he will send, amen, an encouraging word, whether it be through an angel, whether it be through a man of God, whether it be through a woman of God, or whether it be through a psalm. However God choose, amen, to speak to us and to encourage us at that time, he will use something, amen, to tell us who we are. And when he tells us and reminds us of who we are, we have to quickly come in agreement with it. Somebody said, quickly come in agreement with it. And so here, the angel of the Lord, in effect, was saying to Gideon, Gideon, listen up. Listen, you are stronger than you think you are. You are letting this situation overwhelm you. You think it's unbearable. You think it's too much to handle. But I'm here to tell you, you got what it takes. And sometimes that's why it's important to have the right people around you and the right people, amen, in your circle. That when you're going through down moments in your life, they're able to speak into your life. They're able to tell you what the word of God says about you. You got to be careful. You got to handpick these people. You can't just allow anybody to be, amen, in your circle and sit on the front row. You got to make sure, amen, that they got a relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. They have been ordained to be a part of your life and your walk with God. Because when you go through those things, amen, God will use them, amen, to speak an encouraging word into your life. And that's what this angel's job was to speak an encouraging word to Gideon and to let him know, amen, who he was in Christ Jesus. Amen. The angel of the Lord wanted him to know, Gideon, listen, you think this opposition is more powerful than you, but I'm here to tell you, amen, that you are a mighty man of God. You are a vigilant hero. You are God's man. And so the more that angel pumped Gideon up and begin to tell him and remind him who he was, amen, then what happened, Gideon came in agreement to what the angel was saying. And whenever you come into agreement with what God says about you, let me tell you something, that's the thing that will light your fire. That's the thing will cause you to lift up your head. That's the thing that will open up your heart and allow your ears to hear what the Spirit is saying unto the church. Amen. Gideon, he's there. And he's hearing this angel saying, you are strong. You are a valiant man of God. You are God's hero. Amen. And Gideon didn't understand how it was that he was in this situation, but yet God didn't leave him there. So God sent that angel to tell Gideon that who he was, amen, in God. And once Gideon got that thing down on the inside of him, like, I need you to get this word on the inside of you this morning, then you can do all things through Christ Jesus. The fact is, my brothers and sisters, you are more equipped than you realize. Amen. Yes. Sometimes it may feel like it's too much to bear. Sometimes it feels like the defeat is about to overwhelm you. But God wouldn't have never allowed that situation or temptation to come into your life unless he was not going to deliver you out of it. Amen. The fact of it is, amen, that you can handle it, amen, through God's grace. Somebody said, by the grace of God, I can handle us. I wish you would get excited with me this morning and stand up and shout and let the devil know, amen, that by God's grace, amen, you can handle this. You were built for this moment. Why don't you be bold enough to tell the devil out loud, devil, I'm built for this moment. So whatever you got for me, bring it on, because me and Jesus together, amen, we can handle this thing. We can do all things through Christ who strengthened us. Now, Gideon, he heard the angel of the Lord speaking this thing, these words of encouragement to him. And when Gideon came in agreement with what the angel was saying, the Bible says, amen, that Gideon got strong and he stood up and he was what God said he was. He was a mighty hero. He was full of faith, amen, ready to take on the enemy and not hide anymore. And if you don't know what you have, I want you to know God will let you know. He's not going to let you stay in that situation and not let you know what you got down on the inside of you. You got to find somebody, amen, that's in your circle to help remind you who you are in God. And so Gideon, amen, once he found out and came in agreement with who he was in God, the Bible says, amen, that Gideon called his men together. He called his men together and they snuck down, a couple of them snuck down into the enemy's camp. And when they got to the enemy's camp, the Bible says Gideon heard some of the Mennonites saying, well, you know what? Gideon and the people of God, amen, God's going to allow them to have victory over us because they are stronger than we are. Let me tell you something. Even the enemy knows, amen, your position in God. You're not hearing me this morning. I'm trying to tell somebody, even the enemy knows your position in God. He knows exactly, amen, where you are and who you are in God. And so when Gideon and a few of his men snuck down there, and heard the enemy even saying they are mighty men of God. Amen. The Bible says Gideon and a few of his men, they went on back. He told his men, he said, let me tell you something. We can win this battle. It was so many of them, but Gideon only had about 300 men. But I want you to understand this morning. Amen. It doesn't matter how many people you got on your side, but what matters is who's on your side. And Gideon had God on his side, even though he was outnumbered, amen, the mere fact was he had God on his side. And because he knew he had God on his side, he was no longer intimidated. He was no longer weak. He was no longer fearful. But Gideon, amen, went and went into that battle based on what the angel of the Lord had said to him and how he had come in agreement with what that angel of the Lord had said. And the Bible says, amen, they defeated the enemy. Let me tell you something. Yes, you may think you're too small. You may think you only know a few scriptures. But let me tell you something. When you're in the heat of the battle, you don't have to know Genesis through Revelation. It's good to know. But let me tell you something. All you need is one good scripture. Amen. And believe that scripture and quote that scripture out loud. And let me tell you something. God will honor that scripture in the face of the enemy. And he will allow you to be victorious every time. You no longer have to feel weak. You no longer have to feel intimidated. You no longer have to feel overwhelmed, because I want you to know God is with us. Now, don't get me wrong, and I don't want you to think that I know sometimes you don't feel human, because we got a human side just as well as a spiritual side. And sometimes these feelings come, and sometimes these feelings overwhelm us. But we don't live by our feelings. We live by faith. You hear what I'm saying to you this morning? Feelings change. One day you feel good. The next day you don't feel good. That's why our salvation is not based on our feelings. Salvation, amen, is based on what you know. Somebody help me go through here this morning. Amen, amen. So don't lean and depend on how you're feeling, because one day you may feel like you can defeat the enemy, but the next day your feelings may say, oh no, I'm too weak and I can't win this battle. You got to know what you know, amen, and know, amen, that it's not based on your feelings, but who you are in Christ Jesus. And so when these feelings come to overwhelm us, we got to stand up and we got to be able to speak to the feelings and say, not today. You're not going to get in my way today. I'm going to defeat the enemy in the name of the Lord. And so that's what Gideon did. Amen. Because what the angel of the Lord spoke to him, he came in agreement with it. He came alive in his spirit, and God gave him and his 300 men victory over the devil. And I want you to know this morning, God can do the same thing for you. So pick your head up, put a smile on your face, stop your crying, wash off your face, stand up and come in agreement with who God said you are. And let me tell you something, amen, God will allow you to be victorious, just like he allowed Gideon to be victorious. God just didn't bring you this far to let the enemy just stomp you down and beat you up. But if God allowed it, then God already knows what you got on the inside of you and what you will need, amen, to be able to defeat the enemy. And so understand, you have everything that you need. You were built for the moment. Somebody say, built for the moment. I need you to come in agreement with me and come in agreement with what God is saying about you, that you are built for the moment. Whatever that temptation that you're facing right now, whatever that situation is, whatever feel that pressure that may have you overwhelmed, you are built for the moment of the situation, and God will allow you to escape. Y'all not hearing me? He will give you a way to escape. Amen. Whatever it is, if you are bold enough to believe, amen, and come in agreement with what God says about who you are and what you are, then you are able to defeat, amen, that temptation. Let me see if I can help you to understand what I'm trying to say. I was born in Louisa County. I'm a country boy. And so my dad, they farmed a lot. He put in gardens. And as I was growing up, I watched him put a garden together. I watch him go down and plow up the ground and got ready for sowing season. And I remember he would come home and he would have packages of seeds of different vegetables that he was going to grow in the ground, that he was going to put in the ground. But let me tell you something, as long as those seeds stayed in that package, all they were was just pretty little seeds. Amen. But what matters is when the seed come out of the package and it's put into the ground. Hear me, somebody, because I'm trying to help somebody to see yourself and where you are. You may seem small, but let me tell you something, you are mightier than you realize. And so growing up, watching my daddy cut the rows through the garden and putting in the fertilizer, and then he would put the seed in the ground. And those little seeds would be very tiny. They would be really small. But those seeds are not effective until they get under the dirt. Somebody need to hear me this morning. I'm coming to you to let you know, amen, as the seed goes under the dirt, then that seed will begin to germinate. Amen. It will open up, and somehow, amen, it doesn't matter how much dirt is on top of that seed got power to burst open and push the dirt up off of the seed. It breaks the ground. What are you saying this morning, Bishop? I'm trying to say, somebody this morning, you feel like you're overwhelmed. You feel like you're covered in dirt. You feel like you're buried up. You feel like you're in the dark and you just can't burst through. But I'm trying to tell you, just hang in there. Amen. It doesn't matter what seemed like, how much is on top of you. Amen. God's seed, amen, is going to allow you to burst through whatever is holding you down. And so I remember growing a garden just last year, and I remember putting in some lima beans, and it looked like it was taking so long. And so one day I went down to the garden and I began to look to see if there was any signs of it coming up. And there I saw on the ground where I had planted those lima beans, amen, the ground was popping open, which means that dirt had laid on top of that seed had begun to germinate. And when the seed starts to germinate, whatever is on him, it's got to get up off of it. Y'all not hearing me? What are you saying, Bishop? I'm trying to tell somebody this morning, you are a seed of God. And whatever is on top of you, it's got to get up off of you, y'all. Not helping me here. I'm trying to tell somebody, God have created something inside of you that will allow whatever is on you, amen, to get up off of you. That's right. It's got to get up off of you. Wherever you are this morning, stand up and declare and let the devil know you got to get up off of me, because, amen, I'm God's child. I'm a seed of God. And if you can declare that, amen, and let the enemy know who you are, amen, whatever he has sent your way, it's got to get up off of you. I know somebody may be feeling like you're overwhelmed, amen, you're not feeling well, but let me tell you something. Once you know who you are in Christ Jesus, whatever that thing is that got you down, it's got to get up off of you, because God has given you power. God has put something down on the inside of you that will push everything that feel like it's got you overwhelmed. And so, amen, understand, yes, maybe the seed thought, yes, I'm just down here, I'm under the ground, and all this heavy dirt is on top of me. But I want you to know, the seed didn't know the power that it had until it began to germinate and bust open. And once it began to bust open, amen, then it can begin to sprout up, to become what it is. Somebody this morning that's listening to me, the devil has put a whole lot of mess on you to make you feel like, amen, that you weren't created to be who you are. But I'm trying to tell you this morning, I come with an encouraging word to let you know that you are everything that God said you were going to be. You've got the power, amen, inside of you. God has designed you, he has equipped you, and he has built you for the moment to get whatever that's on top of you off of you. Somebody say, it's got to get up off of me. I wish you get excited with me and talk back to me this morning and let the enemy know you got to get up off of me. Amen. I'm designed, I'm built for the moment, and you're not going to keep me down. Listen, don't get fooled by how much dirt weighs. Amen. The dirt is only just getting you ready to flourish and be who you are. But as long as you stay in the packet, amen, and never get into the ground, you can never become who God designed for you to be. And so hear me this morning, my brothers and sisters, you were built for the moment. So whatever pressure, whatever the enemy has sent your way, amen, don't run. Don't throw in the towel, don't fall to pieces, because God is about to show you, amen, everything you got down on the inside of you to let you know, amen, that you are built for the moment. Somebody say, built for the moment. Tell your neighbor, I know we ain't in church, but it sounds good this morning. Tell whoever is next to you, I'm built for the moment. Yes, we're built for the moment. And so understand, we have seen a whole lot of things come our way in the last year. Some overwhelming stuff. We've seen family members get sick. We've had family members to die from COVID-19. We've had family members to lose their job. We've had family members, amen, to get evicted. But I want you to know, all of that ain't big enough to hold you down, because God has created something inside of you to let you know who you are in Christ Jesus. I'm reminded of a story in Numbers chapter 11, where the Bible says at one point in Moses' life, he felt overwhelmed. He was leading the children of Israel, amen, in the desert. Some 2 million people he was trying to lead to the promised land. And let me tell you something, you know how it is. If you ain't got no more than 5, amen, you know it can be difficult when you got more than one person and you got to lead them somewhere. Moses had 2 million people that he had to lead to the promised land. Can you imagine what type of burden he was under? All those people complaining, all those people grumbling, saying, Moses, why in the world did you bring us out here? You should have just left us back there with Pharaoh and the flesh pots of Egypt instead of bringing us out here to die. They was complaining. Amen. They were crying. Nothing suited them. You know how people is. Anytime you got more than two or three people, rest assured, amen, you can expect some trouble. You can expect some people to grumble. You can expect some people to complain, but Moses here, the Bible says in chapter 11 of Numbers and verse 11, he said, God, why did you lay this burden of all these people on me? They are not my children. I'm not able to bear all of this stuff. It's too heavy for me. Moses felt pressured and he felt stressed out. And there are moments, saints of God, when you're going to feel pressured. There are moments when you're going to feel stressed out. But listen, I want you to know, even though Moses had a heavy load on him, God still allowed him to lead those people to the promised land. And I want you to know this morning, whatever you're pressured with, whatever you feel like it's got you overwhelmed, God's going to allow you to get just where he said that he's ordained for you to get. God had called 70 men. 70 elders could help him. And verse 7 in Numbers chapter 11 said, God said, I will take some of the spirit that's on you, and I'm going to put it on some of these 70 men that I've allowed to go with you. They will help you carry the burden. What are you trying to say, Bishop? I'm trying to tell you, saints of God, when God gives you an assignment, sometimes he will allow people to help you along the way. But you got to know who it is that God has designed to help you. Because if you don't have the spirit of discernment to know who it is that God has sent to help you while you feel pressured and overwhelmed, these people can take you to a place where you shouldn't be going. Y'all not hearing me this morning. That's why you got to know the Bible says, try the spirit by the spirit. Amen. Just because somebody smile in your face, just because somebody tell you something that they think you want to hear, that does not mean, amen, that's the person that God want in your inner circle. You got to see that spirit. Y'all not hearing me. You got to hear that testimony. You got to see what God have allowed them to go through. Because let me tell you something, there's only a few that is designed to walk with you. Y'all not hearing me. Here we are. We're in this global pandemic. God is doing a reconstruction. He's resetting things. And when God begins to reset things, amen, he's going to move some people out of the way. Not that they were all bad, but those people can't go with you the rest of the way that you're going. And so not that you're trying to throw them away, but where you're going now, God says, I got some more people that's designed and built for the moment to walk with you where I'm trying to take you. I wish I had somebody to hear me this morning. And so God says, Moses, don't you worry. I'm going to take some of your spirit and I'm going to put it on some of these men, and they're going to help you to bear this load. Amen. You got so much potential. Hear me, somebody. You're listening to me this morning. You need to know that you got potential. Amen. That you have yet to tap into. But all God needs is a willing spirit. How many says, I'm willing this morning? God need a willing spirit. Are you willing to go the rest of the way? God will send you just what you need, amen, to get where God has designed for you to go. I got to get out of here. My time is almost up. But I want to tell you, when you get overwhelmed and you start thinking that you can't handle it, you need to know that God says you are a mighty hero. You got can-do power. Somebody say can-do power. If you can get excited with me this morning and begin to lift your hands and give God a hand praise, begin to put those hands together and give God some praise and glory right now, just for a few minutes. Just take a few minutes out and give God some praise for the mere fact that whatever that you've been dealing with, you are still able to hear this message this morning. It's not by accident. Amen. God knew what you needed when you need it at the right time. Hear me, somebody, this morning, come on, get excited with me. Give God some praise and say, Lord, I thank you that even though this situation felt like it was overwhelming and it was too much for me, I'm built for the moment. That's right. I come to tell somebody this morning, you are built for the moment. So whatever you got, whatever you're facing, amen, God is not gonna let you fall to defeat, because he knows exactly and what he has put down on the inside of you. And it doesn't matter, saints of God, whether you've been walking with God for 20 years or 1 year, for the mere fact that you can come in agreement with whatever God says at the moment that he says it, amen, you can do it. Somebody say, I can do it. Y'all not hearing me? You don't have to have a degree behind your name. You don't have to have bishop in front of your name. All God needs is a willing vessel that says, I can do. Somebody said, I can do. It doesn't matter, saints of God, whether you're 6'1", 6'2". It doesn't matter whether you got muscles or don't have muscles. Let me tell you something. God can use anybody that has a willing spirit. Come here, David. Talk to us this morning. The Bible says David was a little teenager boy. Y'all not hearing me this morning. He was out there in the field tending the sheep for his father. And Samuel came getting ready to anoint the next king. When he got to Jesse's house, he said, where are all of your boys? He looked at those who were in the house. He said, no, it ain't none of them. Do you have any more sons? And they said, yeah, David. David is out in the field. David was just a little ruddy boy. He was just a little small something. But I want you to know this morning, saints of God, God can take something that is small and he can make it mighty. And the Bible says when they went and got David and brought him in the house and Samuel pulled the oil on his head and the oil began to run, Samuel said, that's the next king of Israel. No, not hearing me. It don't matter how big you are, how little you are. God can use you. I wish I had somebody. And the Bible says, as David began to, he had this anointing on his life to be the next king, but he just didn't go to the throne right then. But God still used him. So one day his daddy sent him out into the field and said, David, take your brother some lunch. When David got out there where his brothers was, the Bible says he saw all of them standing around in fear. And a big giant standing out there on the field, cursing the people of God, cursing God, and saying all kinds of things. And David said, what in the world is going on out here? How in the world can y'all allow this uncircumcised Philistine to call God all these names and to have y'all in fear? David said, if y'all scared to fight it, then I'll go out there and fight it. As little as David was, he knew who he was in God. He had faith in God that no matter how small he was, God would give him the victory. And he was, the Bible says he took his slingshot and a few stones and he went out there because David knew he was built for the moment. And that's what I come to tell somebody this morning on this Sunday, this wintry mix Sunday morning, that you are built for the moment. David went out there, defeated Goliath, chopped his head off. Y'all not hearing me? You need to let the enemy know, amen, you're about to chop his head off. You're about to put something, I wish I had somebody, you're about to put something on the devil. Somebody get excited with me, amen, and say, I got can-do power and I'm built for the moment. Say it out loud. I'm built for the moment. Come here, Jesus. Amen. You were God's only begotten son. You came into a sin-sick world. Amen. You walked and healed the sick and raised the dead. But Jesus had an assignment. Amen. The miracles were only just byproducts. But his assignment was to come to the world and make his way to the cross and die for the sins of the world. When Jesus was hanging there, the Bible says on the cross, he had all this pressure of all the sins of the world. But let me tell you something. Not one time did Jesus buckle. Not one time did Jesus said, I can't do this. Not one time did Jesus
Jesus said, take me down from this. But the Bible says he hung right there until it was finished. And when it was finished, he locked his head in the neck of his shoulder and he gave up the ghost and they put him in a borrowed tomb. But even the borrowed tomb wasn't strong enough to hold him down. 3 days later, the Bible says Jesus got up. God raised Jesus from the dead with all power in the palm of his hand. And now Jesus sits on the right hand of the Father and he makes intercession for us. He was built for the moment to come into a sin-sick world and die for my sins and your sins. So somebody this morning, you feel like you're left out. You feel like you're overwhelmed. But let me tell you something. Because of what Jesus did on Calvary, you are built for this moment. Maybe this is your first time hearing the gospel of Jesus Christ, knowing that God loved you so much that he gave his best. He took the best that he had and he sent it in your place to die for your sins so that you can have a right to the tree of life. And let me tell you something. It doesn't matter where you've been. It doesn't matter what you did. It doesn't matter how you grew up and what family you grew up in. If you can trust the finished work of God, amen, the Lord Jesus Christ can save you just like he saved me. Let me tell you something. I was a wretch undone. I wasn't fit to live and I wasn't ready to die, but I'm so glad that the God that I serve, amen, came and sent his only begotten son to die for the sins of the world. And the moment I accepted Jesus Christ as my savior, he came in, amen, and began to live in me. And ever since that day, I've been running for him. And guess what? I'm built for the moment. Whatever the devil got to send my way, I'm built for the moment because I know who I am in Christ Jesus. I got to get out of here. But I needed to tell somebody this morning that's going through, somebody that's overwhelmed, somebody that feels pressure, somebody that's getting ready to throw in the towel. Don't do it. You are built for the moment. You got everything that you need to handle that situation. So get up, shake it off, open up your mouth and give God a praise. Lift your hands up and give God some glory and let him know, yes, God, I'm in agreement with you. I'm built for the moment. I've got to go. Ella Jeffcoat is going to take you the rest of the way. God bless you. Please, please hit the share button so somebody else can get this message. Somebody need to hear what the Spirit is saying unto the church. I got to get out of here. I'll see you next Sunday in Jesus' name.